Hello guys, today I'm going to talk about how to apply for permanent residency in Australia. I lived in Australia for 8 years and I have experience. So I'm going to talk about how you can get a permanent residency in Australia. So first, you need to know what is permanent residency. It's short for PR. PR, it means permanent residency. In US, people call it a green card. And in Australia, in Canada, people call it a permanent residency. So PR is American. Now, PR is Australian green card, and with this green card, or with this PR, you can live, work, study indefinitely in Australia. And you have rights, unlimited number of hours to work in Australia. You can apply for a farewell, and it's pretty much like a citizenship. But there are some differences between PR and citizenship. PR, you cannot vote. You don't have political rights. But if you have citizenship, you can vote for candidates. You have political rights in Australia. You can work for government. So the political rights is the difference between PR holders and citizens of Australia. I think this is the primary difference. Of course, there are some other small differences, but just small, not important. The most important difference is the political difference. If you want to become Australian citizen, first you need to become PR holder in Australia. So let's talk about the PR holder first. How do you become PR? How do you get this PR in Australia? There are a few different streams. I'm going to talk about one of the streams. So the streams includes investment, marriage, skilled migration, refugee, and other streams. Today I'm going to talk about skilled migration only. I talk about this because I came to Australia as an international student. I heard many stories about this. I heard the stories of many international students applying for PR in Australia. So I have many experience, rich experience about how do people get PR from skilled migration stream. First, you come to, if people want to get a PR from the skilled migration stream, they firstly come to Australia as an international student. And they usually study in Australia. And when they study in Australia, they need to collect the points. The points is set by Australian Immigration Department. The minimum points they need to collect is 65. The more the better. But the minimum, the bottom line is 65 points. So if they have 65 points, and those points include many different categories, includes age, work experience, language ability, professional registration, which university you studied, which region you studied in Australia. So it includes many different categories. And they will get a assessment according to those categories. So they need to get at least 65 points. For example, if someone owning have 60 points, and they need 5 more points, and they need to, you know, try to improve themselves, you know, by take language exams, by work in company to get experience. So they need to collect points. And after they get 65 points, the second step is they need to have a nomination, occupation nomination. So skilled migration requires two parts. First is migration points. Currently, the minimum point is 65 points. And the second part is occupation nomination. So they need to have an nominated occupation to support their claim to be a skilled worker. Many Chinese people use occupation of accountants. So they study accounting in university. After they get a degree, they need to get themselves registration, professional registration as an accountant in Australia. After they get this registration, they get an occupation nomination. And if they have 65 points, and they can use the nominated occupation and the 65 points to apply for PR. So it's quite simple, but it's not very easy to get Australian PR nowadays. Because I said 65 points is minimum points. You can apply for, but because there are too many employers, and if you have 65 points, but other people have 95 points, and 65 points is not enough. So in theory, you can apply for a PR, but in practical, in reality, 65 points is not enough. Many people have to get 85 points, 90 points, you know, to get the application approved. The competition is fierce. It used to be easier, but in recent years, because there are too many applicants, and there are not enough occupation for people. You know, there are too many competition, so it drives the immigration points up. And it's very hard to get 85 points. It's very hard to get 90 points. It's very hard. You have to pass very difficult language test. You have to work for many years to get experience. You know, I know it because I came to Australia as an international student, and I got a PR. I'm a PR holder. And actually, I'm a citizen of Australia now. So I experienced all of the process of applying for PR, for citizenship in the past 8 years. So I also heard stories from many people's immigration story. You know, the process takes a long time and it's not easy. It is extremely difficult, and it becomes very, very difficult nowadays. Okay, so if you have questions, you can ask me and I will try to answer your question. Bye-bye, guys. Hi, I just realized the video is 9 minutes and 10 seconds long. So I needed to... I want the video has 10 minutes long, so that's why I'm still talking. I'm keep talking for 50 seconds more. I'm still in Melbourne, and the weather is pretty nice. It's winter in Melbourne, but it's pretty warm. That's why I think Australia is better than Canada. Before I came to Australia, I used to thinking about going to Canada, because it's close to US. But you know, the weather in Canada is pretty cold. Look at today's weather in Melbourne in winter. But the weather is beautiful. So that's the reason I didn't go to Canada. Instead of going to Canada, I came to Australia. Okay, bye bye guys. The more the better.